Cruella DeVille acrylic painting on shoes by Hot Pink Zebra Paper.
Hi everyone! In today's video, I'm going to be showing you another pair of shoes that I've painted. I am really into painting shoes because it's something that you can paint, and depending on the material, it's really, it holds up very, very well, and you can wear them out and about, and it's just kind of a wearable art that you can do that way. So, I hope you guys like these as much as I do. They are Cruella with dog prints. I love Cruella. She is one of my favorite Disney villains, and actually before I started this channel, I did a Cruella sculpture that I'm really sad I didn't record and didn't get available for you guys on this because I'm so happy with the way it turned out, but yeah, I did that too long ago, unfortunately. But I really love Cruella, and I hope you guys like this one too. I also have a nail art design I just did that's Cruella themed that's on my art channel. I'll put a link to that in the description box below, and don't forget to click subscribe to see all my future videos as well.
So to begin with, I'm going to start with, it's actually kind of like a purplish nude color paint, so she's got kind of a dead skin tone, so it's either like a little bit, mix either some gray into your nude or your fleshy color, your light peach, or some purple, or a little bit of green, just kind of make her skin tone not as bright and healthy as you normally would use. So, after I did that, I'm just going to add a little bit of, so I first painted her face, like the shape of her face and her neck, and then when that's still wet, I'm blending in some charcoal paint over her eye sockets, just because she's got like a little bit of that gaunt, shadowed look. And you're also going to want to do that, I continued it down her chest, the color, and then I'm going to blend a little bit of gray right under her chin, just to kind of differentiate between chin and neck. So now with black paint, I'm going to be with a striper brush. I'm just going to go through, or a liner brush, depending on, you know, different names. I'm going to be outlining the black areas. So she's got her black side of her hair and her black dress. So the reason I'm doing this with just this little striper brush first is I'm going to go over, I just kind of go over all the lines that, all the outside lines for this. So I'm basically outlining everything, and then I'll go through and fill it in. Painting on this shoe is not exactly an exact process. It is a canvas shoe, which makes it so that it does paint and the paint does soak in, and it's gonna be durable and all of that material stuff that you really need to think about when you're deciding on what shoes to paint. A pair of shoes that is absorbent is really what you need, and this canvas does do that. However, unlike a canvas that you'd normally paint on, it's not gessoed, so it really is not a smooth surface to paint on. So if you have that striper brush and you have those clean lines from the striper brush, you're gonna have a much better result once you start filling it in, whereas just with that bigger brush, you know, you kinda, it makes little scratchy marks and it's not quite as clean looking. So I like to start with just having that little base done with the white. So then I'm going to do the white side of her hair, same thing, do the outline with that, and then fill it in with the brush. And I didn't do this for everything, but especially with that black and the white, those colors are just so abrupt that I really want, and they're so important because it's her hair and her dress and her face. I wanted everything there to look really clean, so I did those with the striper brush. So now I'm going to be painting her coat. She's got a very fluffy, fluffy coat, and I started with a gray color, and then I'm going to be blending in white mostly, but then just a little bit of a charcoal color paint just to brighten and darken, you know, shadows, highlights, all of that good stuff. And it's just kind of wrapping right around that side of her hair, and then it kind of goes down and it's covering up part of her dress on the white side of her hair for this shoe. Now when you're doing this, you have to, if you're doing two shoes that have the same image like I did, with Cruella you have to, I know it's really easy in my computer, I can just flip the image horizontally, and so I get a mirror image to paint the other side to paint from. Makes it so easy to do. The one thing you do have to keep in mind though is that with Cruella you cannot flip her hair. So on the other shoe, her hair, you know, you just, when you flip the image so that it's the backwards way, the area of her hair that's white on the picture, you have to do black, and because you can't rotate this her hair, because her hair is dyed the way it's dyed. So I don't know if you guys could see that in the beginning image of the shoes that I did, that everything is opposite except for her hair. That was one of the first things my mom noticed. She goes, "You forgot to flip the colors of her hair." I said, "No, I didn't. I specifically did not flip the colors of her hair, because you can't. She doesn't. She could be turned the other direction, but she's not gonna dye her hair wrong. Who's gonna dye their hair wrong?" So anyways, I just wanted to mention that. So now I also, with that same fur coat color, you're gonna wanna paint her purse, and then I'm going to be adding her hands. So I have the cuffs of her coat painted, so I know where her hands start. So then I'm just gonna be adding her hands with red, and as you can see, I'm not doing that with the liner brush either. I just have a smaller brush that I'm using, and it works perfectly fine. My red paint is very, it has a very good consistency to it, so I wasn't really worried about it making those little scratchy marks. And once you start painting on top of paint, so once you start the little areas that you've already painted on, if like right here on her elbow, you're painting over paint, it goes so much smoother. If the paint's dry, if the paint's wet, you're probably gonna end up with a mess. But if the paint is dry, it's so much easier to paint over those areas than the areas that are still canvas shoe that haven't had any paint absorb into them yet. So that's definitely a little easier. So once you start adding some of the details later, it gets a little bit easier to work with. And these shoes that I'm using, these are actually shoes that were I bought at a craft store that were made for crafting. So these shoes are intended to be enhanced, which I thought was really cool. I hadn't even thought of looking for shoes at a craft store before. So now I'm going to be filling in the little gaps in her coat, so where the lining is showing. So there's a little bit on each side of her with a kind of a terracotta orange color. So just fill that in there. So there's just a little bit on each side where, you know, her coat's open a little bit. She's kind of like, you know, she's not too worried about it. She's not holding it closed. And I'm also, with that same color, that same terracotta color, I also added the little bar that and the clasp on the top of her purse, as well as the little beaded handle. Those I did highlight with gold later on, but for now I just decided to do them with the same color, just kind of get that base down, and then the gold highlight looked and distinguished them later. So with teal, I'm going to be painting her cigarette holder. Then I added the little cigarette end with red, highlighted that with white so it wasn't quite the same red as her gloves, and then add the one earring that shows and the ring that's on the finger that is on the hand on her hip. And now for the fun part, I'm going to be painting all of the details on her face. This is my favorite part of painting Cruella. She's got such a detailed, amazing face that I love it. So I'm going to start with black outlines for her eyebrows. I added just a little bit of a line for the top of her nose. And I'm also going to be outlining her eyes. She's got wonderful eyeliner on. When you do the outlines for her eyes, don't continue them all the way into that inner corner because they don't actually go all the way. It's basically what you're doing is her eyeliner, and she doesn't have eyeliner that's completely circumferencing her eye. It just goes right to the corner on the top and then halfway on the bottom. So then you're also going to want to do her lips. And then add a little bit of black on the sides to kind of make her teeth, you know, differentiate her teeth. Fill in her teeth with white. And then I'm going to add just a very thin black line between her rows of teeth, really to make sure that they are distinguished. And then I'm going to be adding her eyes with white. I also touched up a little section of her hair with that white as well, there was one part that got a little bit covered up by coat that shouldn't have, so I fixed that up at that point. And then I'm going to be adding her eye shadow with a really pretty kind of an olivey green. And then I highlighted her eyelids with just a dab of white, blending that into the center of her eyelids. And then adding her pupils with black. The one thing when you're painting on this is that the acrylic paint takes a little bit longer to dry because it's a very thick coat. Just because it soaks into the material, it takes more paint. So you have a little bit more time to do things like blending and that sort of thing than you might otherwise. So I added the little smoke out of her cigarette with green, which I missed talking about, but just add with a little bit of that same green as her eyelid, just kind of swoofy lines coming up. And then I highlighted the chain and the clasp and the little bar at the top of her purse with that really metallic gold color I have. And now I'm going to be adding all of the outlines on Miss Cruella. So I'm pretty much outlining just about everything. The one thing you don't have to worry about outlining is her facial features that don't have it. So you don't have to outline her eyelids or her lips. Those things don't need them. And they don't have them, so don't worry about it. And you don't really have to worry about outlining any of the black areas. So you don't have to worry about outlining her dress or her black hair. However, if you do have a little area that wasn't quite perfect before doing this outlining, you can really touch up those black areas if you need to. So if you need to add a little wispy hair here, or maybe her dress got a little bit messed up when you're painting other things around it, you can fix those up easy enough at this point. But you don't have to do like a full outline because it's black on black and nobody's going to see it anyway. So after you've got everything else outlined, this is very important to do, especially on this hand that's holding the cigarette, because she's got those little fingers that otherwise really get lost. So you really want to make sure that you are outlining those fingers and the cigarette holder, make sure everything's very easy to see. The one thing about doing this is that since it is a shoe, you want to make sure that your image is clearly visible from 5 feet away or something, you know, from a distance. So you want to make sure that your outlines aren't necessarily overbearing, but they're present, because that's just going to make it easier to see what it is that you're looking at. And so don't skip the outlining. I know sometimes it's like, oh, do I really want to outline? It looks really good as it is. It's just going to make it look a little cleaner, and it's going to make it more visible from a greater distance. And especially, like I said, with something like shoes, you want it to be instantly recognizable. You want to just be walking and have somebody go, oh, Cruella shoes. That's kind of what your goal is, or whatever is on your shoes. You want it to be something that's that you can tell. So I also, with charcoal paint, I added all of the spots on her coat. And so now I'm going to be painting puppy prints going around the outside of the shoe. So I'm going to be having, this is the same charcoal. I'm not using black paint. The reason I'm not using black is because I wanted the darkest areas of the shoe, of the design, to be her hair and her dress and, you know, her pupils and her eyebrows and those features on Cruella herself. I didn't want them, I wanted those to be bolder and more intense than everything else. So you want to avoid using black paint in other areas of the design except for just on Cruella. So that's why with charcoal paint, I'm just painting these puppy prints going all the way around the backside of the shoe. So I hope you guys like these. I am so excited to wear them. I absolutely love them. They're amazing. Please share any recreations with me on Facebook or Instagram, and definitely check out my Facebook and Instagram to see other things of my art. I've done some commission pieces and different things that I haven't been posting on YouTube, so check there to see those, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!